We've heard a lot this afternoon about real data, but I think it would help members, and particularly I remember my colleague from Berks County, who is undecided, to take a look at some of the documentation here that PERC has provided us. Let me start by talking about what happens when you move cash flow. In other words, we're going to be taking the incoming money into these pension systems and reducing it in the hybrid plan. And many believe, and including actuaries that have taken a look at this, that the transition of going into Senate Bill 1 will have significant costs that relate to the fact that there will be less cash flow. And cash flow is enormously important when you're talking about these pension plans, because it really helps to dictate how much these pension funds can invest, how much they have to put into liquid assets, and what the assumed rate of return is. So our assumed rate of return under these pension plans is currently 7.5%. By the way, they both CSRS and PSRS reduced those assumed rate of returns in the last several years from 8% to 7.5%. That reduction for CSRS alone, and I'm a trustee of the CSRS system, that reduction from 8 to 7.5% in terms of the rate of return, assumed rate of return, resulted in an inflation of the unfunded liability by nearly $2.5 billion. So in other words, as you reduce that assumption, you're going to inflate the unfunded liability. And many folks believe, including the actuaries that PERC has used here, but they can't quantify it, and I'm going to read something to you that I think is very important, believe that there will be an impact. They haven't been able to quantify it by making this transition. So let me read a paragraph from the consulting actuary to the PSRS plan that's in the PERC documentation. And this will tell you that this bill is not ready for prime time, because we're making this decision without the necessary information that each and every one of us should have. Let me read this paragraph. It's a little dry, but I think you need to pay attention. This analysis is based on an assumed 7.5% annual discount rate. However, under Senate Bill 1, it is possible that liquidity considerations may arise due to the shift in liability towards retirees, and the PSRS board may change the asset allocation to reduce the risk of the portfolio and reflect the need to hold a growing proportion of its assets in more liquid, less volatile asset classes. In general, lowering the risk of the portfolio lowers the discount rate used in the system's valuation. This increases the accrued liabilities and the contribution requirements of the system. Therefore, the cost analysis presented will change potentially significantly. Let me say that, potentially significantly, if there is a change in the asset allocation as an expected asset return. However, due to time constraints, this analysis was not performed for this cost note. Due to cost, so we're sitting here making this enormous decision for tens of thousands of retirees that we have a fiduciary responsibility to, hundreds of thousands, without sufficient information. Let me also point you to something else. There's a lot of talk about what reducing the unfunded liability. Again, let me refer you to the PERC actuarial cost impact for both plans. There really is very little difference under existing law versus the amended Senate Bill 1 in terms of the rate that we reduce the unfunded liability. For instance, in 2025, under existing law, the funded ratio is 69.9% for PSRS. Under Senate Bill 1, it's 70%, 0.1%. They both reach 100% funded in the same exact year. So in 2042, under existing law, we become 100% funded for PSERS, and under Senate Bill 1, as amended, 100% in the same exact year. No difference. And we're going to take this out on our employees and our retirees to get the same exact result under SERS. Actually, SERS reduces, under existing law, the unfunded liability more rapidly than amended Senate Bill 1. Again, are we making this decision to basically carve out the future of existing retirees and future retirees, take this out on them, and we're not really getting any benefit out of it? It seems to me that on one hand, there may be an ideological issue here, not a practical solution. And that is what we need to take a look. This is not ready for prime time. The actuarial note doesn't give us sufficient information. It is not responsible. It is absolutely irresponsible for us to be considering this piece of legislation without at least having a full actuarial analysis of the impacts of this bill. You should vote no. This should go back to the drawing board. It is not responsible to pass this bill. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.